Ever since that day you beat me, I've been getting stronger. I'll show you power! Right here! Right now!
You know, I went back and forth for a few weeks about whether or not I really wanted to play this game. I knew it was a remake and I had never played any of the original Mana games on the Super Nintendo, but the gameplay and art style appealed to me, and with the current drought of new games as a result of the coronavirus, I figured I might as well give it a shot. And it ended up being a pretty solid decision. Trials of Mana is a fairly streamlined RPG. Elements like gear, stat changes, and abilities are all present, but they're fairly straightforward and easy to wrap your head around. For the most part, just about anything will work, and the systems aren't too deep. Of the six available characters, you choose one to be your main character, and two more to be your companions throughout the game. Each of those characters fill pretty standard RPG roles, and they're pretty enjoyable to play. Trials of Mana is really just a hack and slash game with RPG elements. As you level your characters up, advance their classes, and gain more abilities, the gameplay really starts to flesh itself out as your basic attacks progress and those abilities are integrated into your combos. The combination of dodge rolling and the red MMO-esque markers for incoming attacks allow for an active and enjoyable combat system that I found myself really liking. I played the game on the hardest difficulty, and while there were spots here and there that were a bit tricky, it really wasn't that bad. I had the most fun as I got into the later portions of the game, and I could chain together all of my really strong abilities in some of the bigger fights. The story isn't anything to write home about. It's a fairly basic story with mediocre English voice acting, but it does its job filling you in on what's going on so that you can get back into the action. And if you don't like it, you can always turn on the Japanese dialogue too. What's really cool about the story though is that it changes a little bit depending on which characters you picked at the beginning of the game. There are three different endings and final bosses to the game, as well as additional story bits if you picked characters whose personal stories intertwine. That, combined with a New Game Plus feature, allows for a ton of replayability, which is always a great thing for a game. I adored the music in this game. Every time I heard a new song, it immediately caught my attention and I was into it. I can't think of a single point in the game where I didn't like the music. It was just pleasant to listen to and made it easy to zone out as I was bashing monsters' faces in left and right. The only real negative thing I can think of is that I had to cap my frame rate at 90 FPS on PC because there was a ton of screen tearing with an uncapped frame rate. But other than that, I had no performance issues. Trials of Mana is a great casual game that allows you to just sit down, switch your brain off, and have a good time. I honestly had zero expectations going into this game and came out of it with a really positive experience. I would totally do another playthrough right now with the three characters I didn't choose if I didn't have a massive backlog of games that I continue to add to. So again, I didn't play the original, so I can't really tell you how it stacks up as a remake, but I enjoyed the game a lot for what it was, and I definitely recommend it to anyone who might be interested. And if you're on the fence about it, Trials of Mana does offer a free download that allows you to play through the first couple hours of the game, so you can play it, try it, and if you like it, when you buy the game, your progress will carry over to the full game, which was pretty cool.